Ladies and gentlemen, HEX community of all ages, hey, Jake Freedom here, coming to you live from YouTube for this week's HEX Update Saturday, which is actually Sunday for November 8th, 2015. And the reason we're doing it on Sunday is not because I didn't really feel like doing it yesterday, but I was watching the StarCraft II Global Finals. Some of you may or may not know that BlizzCon happened over the weekend, and I wouldn't say I'm a huge StarCraft II fan, but I like watching StarCraft players who are really good, and especially the finals, those guys there are just wicked good at that game there. And I don't play it much myself. I've played it a few times, you know, here and there, but I'm not near, I don't think I'm near good enough or fast enough, or don't even play near enough to actually be good at it, so I don't play it a whole heck of a lot. But I do like watching really good players play, and that is the reason why we didn't do the update yesterday, because the round of four, right? Round of four was yesterday, and then the finals there. So it was fun to watch. I like doing that. I do that every year, you know, basically for StarCraft, and I don't really watch anything else other than that. So anyway, on to what happened this week in HEX. What do we have? There's quite a bit, actually. We finally get an article about the second winner of the IQ qualifier here. I think you pronounce his name Dijin. Just call him DJ. I don't know how you actually pronounce his name there, but he's the second qualifier. There's an article here, just like there was for Infamous Neo, and he says that he'd really help if he wins the 40,000 there, if he actually takes first place in the whole thing, it'll really help him out trying to find some real estate, because he says the real estate isn't cheap in capital. I don't exactly know what that means. I'm guessing it's just someplace where he lives. Probably meaning the capital where he lives. I don't know. Anyway, so that's the second winner. We did not find the third winner out last week, and I think there was another tournament this weekend, of course. So hopefully we find out who that is there. Pretty sure there was one this weekend. Let's just take a look real quick here. Yes, yesterday there was one for Constructed, so I didn't look on the forum to see who the actual winner was yet. HEX will probably obviously let us know. So then we had some top 8 invitational qualifier deck lists, and it's pretty interesting. Not a lot of them. There was 1, 2, 3, 4 of the top 8 were the Ruby Wild Ramp decks, but outside of that, you know, we have a Reese deck here that utilizes the Azure Fate Sorceress. Yeah, I wouldn't say this is like a standard deck, but I'm seeing this one more and more now. I don't think this is the standard Reese deck that everybody used to play, but definitely becoming popular. What else was in here? We had another one right there. So then we have a Chronic deck here, which is just utilizes Vampire King, Vampire Princess, Pact of Pain, Arachnophobia there. I don't really want to call this one a spider deck at all, but it's it definitely uses spiders, but I'm gonna guess the Killipedia and the Vampire Kings are probably the cards that are mostly used there for the actual win condition itself. You have some, you know, just a little bit of a removal there, and then you have the Cogtabulous Thirst, target troop +1/+3/-1, draw a card, things like that. So what else do we have? Then we have another one here. This would probably be a spider deck. Actually, this is the one using the tarantulas there. So pretty good. You know, it's definitely not all Ruby Wild Ramp decks, which is good. So I'm glad to see that there. Somebody made a comment last week that I skipped over some of the constructed deck lists, thinking that I only think that the only deck out there is the Ruby Wild Ramp deck, and it certainly is not. It's just, you know, I didn't go over them, and you know, some of the stuff there we've seen in the prior constructed deck list, so I didn't spend a whole lot of time on them. Hopefully you don't think that I think that's the only deck out there. Of course it certainly is not. Then we had a Brew with Hideous Conversion, and I actually saw this on the forums, and I commented on this, and I did a speculation on Hideous Conversion and talked about this card a little bit a few shows back, saying that this card could be something someday, and it looks like somebody had come up with a Brew. I think this is Dino's stuff, right? I think this is what he has done. I think these are his articles here, if I'm not mistaken. It could be wrong. I'm pretty sure it is there. Maybe not. I don't know. But anyway, this particular deck here uses Bunoshi the Ruthless, and that is sacrifice a troop. Another troop gets +2/+2, and we have Mirror Knight, Storm Cloud, Troomshaw, Darkspire Priestess, Darkspire Punisher, Arcane Focus, Replicator's Gambit. Now, putting Replicator's Gambit in here, I'm not really 100% sure on that one, but maybe they have different ideas. I read a little bit of what they talked about in the article here. But Hideous Conversion, you know, you sacrifice a troop, you gain one. If you're sacrificing, like, your Shroomshaw here, you sacrifice that. You'll gain the one, and then it automatically is going to pop out those two battle hoppers, so you can sacrifice those as well to get some. It's kind of like a blood ramp deck almost, but you don't really ramp anything. I mean, you do, but you know. So it's kind of fun to play with Hideous Conversion if you haven't done that. Just try it out. You know, it's pretty interesting to do. Anyway, so I don't know. I haven't checked the price of that card in the auction house when I was doing the speculation. I think it was still pretty cheap. I'm guessing it probably is, as it's not. I haven't seen very many people run that at all. So let's take a look at the constructed deck lists from the 5th of this month here. And let's see what we have here. We have Moonsung, and we got Vampire King, Extinction, Minion. I think I've seen this one. This one's, you know, nothing special, but. Definitely does the job, obviously. And then we have, I'm pretty sure I've seen this one a couple times too. This one just utilizes Angel of Dawn, Deathless Guardian, Druze Colossal Walker. Just some different brews coming out, which is good. Like I said, I don't want you guys to think that I think the only deck out there is the Ruby Wild Ramp deck. Then we have the Winter Moon. This is a little bit different from, you know, the standard Winter Moon decks that we saw for a while. Not insanely different, but it certainly is different. Then we have, as you can see, we haven't come across any Ruby Wild Ramp decks yet. So good that there is a lot of options out there. So, and there's a Cressida deck there. Then we have Urgnok, and this is just the Mono Ruby, which utilizes the Quasha Ridge Tusker. We've all seen that one there before, obviously. And then we have, what else do we have here? We have Angel of Dawn, Repel, Crackling Vortex. See, nothing too odd here. I think the only deck so far that I'd see here that's maybe a little bit different would be this Winter Moon deck. Just not having, doesn't have the cards that you typically see in there. So it's a good brew anyway. Of course, I'll link these decks in the description so you guys can take a look at them if you haven't already. So those are the constructed deck lists, and then they come into the Gauntlet. Now, Gauntlet's a little bit different. Obviously there isn't just the Ruby Wild Ramp deck in here, but there are some of them that show up here as well. Some people, you know, how do I want to say that? Some people think that the Gauntlet is a little bit different because it's just, you know, one and done. Certainly is, you know, other options out there. So just don't think that I think that's the only viable deck out there, because it certainly is not. What else do we have going on here? We have just the HEX update for November news, and they go about the second winner there, and they show off another PvE card here, and it's Glendower. It says when an artifact enters your hand, Glendower gets +1/+1, and his sockets, or not sockets, his slots for his weapon, it says each of your cards named Glendower have, when you play a dwarf, create a random artifact with cost 1 and put it into your hand. That's for his weapon. Then his foot slot is each of your cards named Glendower have, your artifacts in all zones have -1. This seems like it could be a really good card if you're going to play around the dwarf artifact there, because you can be able to play him basically for free. It is interesting that he is the prismatic. I know when they first announced the multi-shard threshold, they called it prismatic, and so I still just say multi-shard threshold. Anyway, so they say the rare prismatic dwarf warrior fits perfectly into established robot decks with those badass pauldrons and glowing axes, you know he's going to be tough. As your robots come into play, Glendower ups his arsenal to get bigger and badder with artifacts, artifactors mallet. That's what we call artifactors mallet. Every dwarf you add to the deck is adding a one drop artifact. You don't have to decide between more dwarfs for support or more artifacts for buffs. Plus, with grounding boots, those artifacts created by the mallet can be played for free. Dwarf decks will receive this reward exclusively as part of the dwarf only quest. So you underworld dwellers should gear up and get ready for Glendower. So as you know, the Haunted Harvest ends Monday. That'd be tomorrow, so you have a couple more days to get your holiday cards. I do have a full playset of the AAs for doing the PvP, entering into tournaments. I haven't done anything with the PvE side of it. I probably should, but just haven't. So yeah, that's about it. And they talk about the ESL stuff, you know, going on. I haven't played in an ESL tournament in a couple of weeks. I've mainly been focusing on just doing the daily sealed, which is a lot of fun. Can be frustrating at times, but you know, I did finally, I don't know if I talked about this. I'm not sure. First couple I just did horrible in, and then I have got a couple tickets. I haven't gone anything over 2-2, unfortunately, which is kind of frustrating, kind of bums me out, but oh well. It's fun. It's just a game. So that's kind of all the news we have there for this week. Let's see. I did get the winners picked for the show, like I did. I missed it last weekend. So for the top five picks, the top five are Thunderbeard, Tibor, Oame, Ligan, and Calyx. Congratulations to you guys. I will get those cards mailed out to you. And for the random weekly pack winner, it's going to be Promenes. And for the Guess My Age birthday contest, a couple of you got it right. And what I'm going to do there is the first one who got it right, I'll give them the pack. So if I tell you who got it right, you'll be able to find out how old I am. And whoever got it right was Sismic. So congratulations to you. You were the first one to actually guess it on the nose. So I'll get that pack mailed out to you as well. Oh, let's see here. Let's go ahead and close this out. And we'll get into the game, and we'll open up this week's pack, and it's just going to be a normal one, nothing too exciting. I know we've had a couple of primal packs back-to-back, well, not quite back-to-back, but at least there anyway. So what do we got? All right, so let's go ahead and grab this week's pack here, open it up, and I'm going to guess it's just going to be a rare. We've been pretty lucky on the legendary, so all right, so it is just a rare, which is fine. So let's go ahead and start with the commons. We have Scraptooth Cackler, Incubate, Scarred Seeker, Gosamir's Tears, Spider Nest, Resource Optimizing Infusion Device, Gem Soul Feeder, Cripple, Ulvir Bashir, Creepy Conspirators, and rounding out the commons is Sudden Awakening. And for the uncommons, we have Temptatious Blade Dancer, Smash to the Ground, and Storm Drummer. And for our rare this week, we have Ashwood Maestro. 2 casting costs, single ruby threshold, 3/1 troop. He is an elf, so it's at the start of your turn. At the start of each champion's turn, they gain 2 temporary resources. I'm not a huge fan of this card, just because your opponent will be able to utilize the card before you, so those aren't, if it was a quick troop, maybe that would be awesome, but oh well, still a decent card, I guess, if you're making an elf deck, maybe, I don't know. Go and stash that away, just a common chest. So let me know what your top five picks are there for this week's pack. I don't think I have anything else. I thought I did, but maybe I didn't. I'll probably think of it after I close out of the show here. I don't know. Again, like I said, I'll link all those articles in the description so you guys can check them out. Let me know your top five picks. If you want to let me know something else, be sure to do that in the comments. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of these, be sure to click subscribe down below, and we'll have another video for you soon.